Governor Cooper has declared a state of emergency for North Carolina because of Tropical Storm Ophelia. Thanks for staying with us. I'm Chris Lovinggood.
And I'm Lena Tillette. WRAL has crews tracking the storm in our studio, live on the ground across several counties, and monitoring conditions using our SkyCam network. Let's get to meteorologist Kat Campbell in the WRAL Severe Weather Center. Kat, we got a major update this hour. A hurricane watch now in effect for parts of our coast.
Yes, and we've been going through the new advisory that came in. A lot of new information to get to. The big one, top winds are at 70 miles per hour. This is a strong tropical storm. 75 miles per hour would be a Category 1 hurricane, and that's why the National Hurricane Center went ahead, erred on the side of caution, and issued the hurricane watches for parts of our coast. So let's take a look at the tropical storm warning. Nobody in our viewing area was placed under the hurricane watch. The tropical storm warning, though, still in effect for the eastern part of our viewing area along and east of I-95 and all of the coast. The hurricane watch is for a smaller portion of the coast close to where we're likely to see Ophelia make landfall. And within the hurricane watch, we just got the text information in from this. From Surf City to Ocracoke, there could be sustained winds of 50 to 65 miles per hour and the potential for winds to gust between 70 and 90 miles per hour. Another big update here, 4 to 6 feet of storm surge will be possible in this region around Moorhead City and Beaufort. We're going to be watching this closely. We have crews at the coast to keep you up to date. I'll have more on our local rainfall coming up.
See you in a bit, Kat. Thanks so much.
And emergency managers in Fayetteville and Cumberland County say they are ready for Ophelia.
WRAL's Fayetteville reporter Gilbert Bays is being told flash flooding and power outages could be the main issues there. Gilbert.
That's right, Lena. You know, we've been down this road before. 2016 Hurricane Matthew, 2018 Hurricane Florence. That's not what this is. Emergency management workers here in Fayetteville and Cumberland County say they are ready for whatever tropical storm Ophelia brings their way.
The promenade flags at Festival Park in Fayetteville tell the story. Vendors are taking extra precautions as they set up tents and tables in preparation for this weekend's International Folk Festival.
What did you do? Do you have things tied down, or how do you?
We have everything banded down. We have weights, we have strings, everything tied down. We didn't put everything out. We just set up, put a tent up, and that was it.
Forecasters say river flooding in our area shouldn't be a problem. Right now, the Cape Fear River in Fayetteville looks just fine. But the threat of high winds forced soldiers from Fort Liberty and volunteers from the Airborne and Special Operations Museum to take down more than 500 flags in the Field of Honor.
We have people who have donated for flags in memory or in honor of a loved one. And the last thing we need is to have that flag end up on Bragg Boulevard.
I talk with Gene Booth. He's the Cumberland County Emergency Management Director. He says there are some obvious concerns with this storm.
The biggest concern would be most likely your typical flash flood low-lying areas that we experience, even during a normal spring or summertime thunderstorm. You know, those areas around the mall, Ramsey Street, MLK, those areas that typically have road street level flooding.
We've checked out some of those areas. Water levels are not that high right now in nearby creeks and streams, but we know that can change in a moment's notice.
And Gene Booth says that they're not planning to open any shelters here in Cumberland County, but they want residents to know they're not sitting on their hands, Lena. They say they are able to open those shelters that they need to and get the Emergency Operations Center up and running in a moment's notice.
That's right. They're ready for whatever comes. Gilbert Bays reporting live for us in Fayetteville. Thank you.
Out to the coast right now here in the WRAL Live Center. Mark Boyle, this is what it looks like out at Nag's Head. This is one location we're seeing a lot of that churned up water. Clearly, in that camera shot, you can see how it is a bit of a mess out there. A little different here. This is Wrightsville Beach. Not as severe, seemingly, in this one location. So we'll keep an eye on things as the conditions definitely will change over the course of the next few hours overnight and into tomorrow morning. Aaron Thomas joining us now live in the Storm Tracker. Aaron, where are you headed this afternoon?
Yeah, so Mark, we're currently in Nash County, Rocky Mount, and since we've been in the WRAL Storm Tracker this evening, the main thing we've been seeing is rain. We'll give you a live look right inside of the WRAL Storm Tracker. It's been heavy rain at times, but for the most part, it's steady. It did start to level off as we were in parts of downtown Rocky Mount, and at some points, we were seeing some ponding on the roads, but so far, we haven't seen any ponding here on 64 westbound as we head towards the triangle, but this is something to keep in mind as more people are getting off of work. It is after Factor 5 is the weekend, so we're expecting more travel here on the roads. I have also been monitoring social media feeds and getting in contact with officials. So far, no damage reports at this time. Back to you.
All right, Aaron, thank you. And right now at 5:35, a live look outside looking at the traffic maps. There are a few issues, the majority of them off to our west side of the viewing area right here on 40. It is slow in and outbound. One crash by the airport, one just west of 540 on the inbound direction. If you're heading in from the Durham area headed into Raleigh, it could slow you down 5 to 10 minutes. Back to you.
Thanks, Mark. This weather alert day is in place through tomorrow afternoon. The WRAL severe weather team will continue tracking the system throughout the weekend. You can stay with us for hourly updates on air throughout the night. We'll have live coverage from the Triangle to the Sand Hills to the coast.
A total of 145 people have been shot in Durham. So